Tyler? Okay. PJ is going to lead the ceremony today in a moment of prayer. Let us pray. Let us pray. Oh, Father, on this wonderful, beautiful day, we come together to celebrate the love of two special and extraordinary people, Laura and Don. We thank you for inviting us to this occasion. We thank you for the blessing of being here. And now we just pray for your spirit as they renew their vows they made 25 years ago to continue to be with them and all of us. We make this our prayer of faith in the name of Jesus the Christ. Amen. Today marks a very special day for Don and Laura, and for those of us who know them well. Exactly 25 years ago, on a mostly deserted beach at sunset in Ocracoke, North Carolina, they committed to each other. I was lucky enough to attend that event, and we are all lucky today to celebrate them with them, the success of that commitment, and to witness the start of the next 25 years of it. I am honored that Don and Laura asked me to officiate the renewals of their vows. I've been fortunate to call both of them friends for nearly three decades. During that time, there have been more joyous occasions than I can count, and a few sad ones I will never forget. Through it all, Don and Laura have taught me what it means to be a good friend and what it takes to have a great marriage. I thank them for their lessons and congratulate them on the example they set. Don't cry.
You're late.
My sense is that Don and Laura asked me to officiate today because of some insight I may have on their journey 25 years in marriage. Like most of you, my friendship with the Austins has provided me terrific memories. They include youthful hijinks, like throwing a king-size waterbed mattress from a building, to late-night snow parties in Rochester involving cars pulling sleds with a ski rope. And those are just to name a few. Those youthful hijinks have naturally been replaced by a more adult shenanigans. I'm certain everyone here has their own story of how their time with the Austins have allowed them to feel a little more carefree, a little more lighthearted, and a little more unrestrained. I think we can all agree that as the older we get, we realize how important those times are and how important it is that we cherish them. Simply put, Don and Laura, love life, and they love living it together to the fullest. In life's biggest moments and in the most ordinary day-to-day activities, they find a reason to laugh with and not at each other. Of all the lessons I have learned from them as a married couple, that is the most important one I have learned. Before getting to the matter at hand, I feel compelled to take a moment to set the record straight on an issue with Laura. I believe the story is that shortly after Don and Laura met, Don informed her that she needed to meet me and get my approval. As most of you know, and maybe you don't, Don and I have been friends for more than 40 years. We value each other's opinions and can give considerable weight to the thoughts of the other. This is particularly true for the most important decisions in our life. My understanding is that Laura thought that our meeting would result in me providing a thumbs up or a thumbs down about her to Don. Basically, she believed that I would provide him an opinion on whether she was good enough for him. Well, I never saw it that way. I considered a request by Don to make sure that what he was feeling for her was as real as he thought. Don was head over heels happy, and I think he was concerned that he was caught up in the moment. He wasn't. I could tell by the look in his eye and the excitement in his voice that he had found someone extraordinary. You guys never needed my approval. Don just needed to be told not to screw it up. And he didn't. And here we are, 25 years later, celebrating their silver anniversary. I can think of... I think it's absolutely appropriate that silver is the symbol of your relationship today. Silver, if you don't know, is the best conductor of thermal heat and electricity. I think that perfectly describes you too. I know of no couple who has more heat and electricity than you guys do. Now on with what we came here to do. Will you continue to have Laura as your wife?
Yeah.
We didn't practice. So to be clear, an acceptable answer is yes, I will, or I do.
I said yes.
So he did get it right.
Yes.
Do you reaffirm your love for her? And will you love, honor, and cherish her in sickness and in health, for richer or poorer, for better or for worse, and forsaking all others, be faithful to her for as long as you both shall live?
I do.
Do you reaffirm your love for him? And will you love, honor, and cherish him for richer or poorer, for better or for worse, and forsaking all others, be faithful to him for as long as you both shall live?
I do.
On your wedding day, you exchange rings as a symbol of the never-ending circle of your love. Rings serve as a reminder of those vows to each other and your commitment to live in unity, love, and happiness. At this time, I'm going to ask you, each of you, to reconfirm the meaning of the rings you wear. Right. If John will place his hand on top of Laura, the ring hand. There you go. Okay. And please repeat after me. Laura.
Laura.
I wear this ring you placed on my hand.
I wear this ring that you placed on my hand.
As a symbol of my love and commitment to you.
As a symbol of my love and my commitment to you.
Now, Laura, if you would put your hand on top of John. Repeat after me. Don.
Don.
I wear this ring you placed on my hand.
I wear this ring that you placed on my hand.
As a symbol of my love.
As a symbol of my love and commitment.
To you.
To you.
I ask that you each continue to cherish each other and that you respect thoughts and ideas of one another. Live each day in love. I know that won't be hard. Always being there to give comfort and refuge in good times and bad. Now, Pastor Joe will lead us in a prayer to bless the ring.
Let us pray. Father, as they have shared their vows and their love for each other, we pray that you might continue to send forth your spirit, that they might continue to live in that love and faithfulness toward each other all the days of their life. Bless their rings, their relationship, their love, their friends, and their family. In the name of Jesus the Christ.
Since I am new to this, I will take the blame for this. Laura has something special that she did want to tell John. So.
Hi. My boo, as we stand here today, I think back of all the wonderful memories we have shared. There's no greater feeling in life than to have your best friend by your side. Though we've had some struggles, our love has been strong enough to conquer them all. I am thankful for you every day. You're the man that I could never imagine that could come into my life that did. You're confident, independent, caring, nurturing, and supportive. And sweating. You make every day on earth worth waking up for. My wish today is that we say these renewals and that you once will say that you do love me and that you will take me to your wife forever. For I will give you all my heart, my soul, my body, and mind every second of every day. I will not only take you as my husband yet again, but as my best friend, my lover, my shoulder when I need to cry, and the person whose arms I can't picture being without. Today, a pleasure to be by your side, to be your strength when you are weak, to never leave you, to be understanding, and to keep being the wife you deserve. I say, I do, take you with my faith, my loving husband, to have and to hold for better or for worse, till death do us.
Oh, not yet.
He's never good at that.
I know. We're basically there. All right. From all of us, friends and family, we ask that you close this ceremony and start the next 25 very happy years of your marriage by showing us that heat and electricity that you are so well known for. Ladies and gentlemen, I now present, once again, Mr. and Mrs. Donald and Laura Austin.